Behold, I will bring evil upon this place, and upon the inhabitants thereof, even all the curses that are written in the book, which they have read before the king of Judah. Because they have forsaken me, and have burned incense upon other gods, that they might provoke me to anger with all the works of their hands. Therefore my wrath shall be poured out upon this place, and shall not be quenched. For the Lord hath a controversy with the inhabitants of the land, because there is no truth, nor mercy, nor knowledge of God in the land. By swearing and lying and killing and stealing and committing adultery, they break out and blood toucheth blood. Therefore shall the land mourn, and everyone that dwelleth therein shall languish with the beast of the field and with the fowls of the heavens, yea, the fishes of the sea also shall be taken away. Yet let no man strive nor reprove another, for thy people are as they that strive with the priests. Therefore shall thou fall in the day, and the prophet also shall fall with thee in the night, and I will destroy thy mother. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, because thou hast rejected knowledge. I will also reject thee, that thou shalt be no priest to me. Seeing that thou hast forgotten the law of thy God, I will also forget thy children. When I bring the sword upon a land, if the people of the land take a man of their coasts and set him for their watchman, if when he see the sword come upon the land, he blow the trumpet and warn the people, then whosoever heareth the sound of the trumpet and take it not warning, if the sword come and take him away, his blood shall be upon his own head. He heard the sound of the trumpet and took not warning, his blood shall be upon him. But he that taketh warning shall deliver his soul. But if the watchman see the sword come, and blow not the trumpet, and the people be not warned, if the sword come and take any person from among them, he is taken away in his iniquity. But his blood will I require at the watchman's hand. So thou, O son of man, I have set thee as a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore thou shalt hear the word at my mouth, and warn them from me. When I say unto the wicked, O wicked man, thou shalt surely die, if thou dost not speak to warn the wicked from his way, that wicked man shall die in his iniquity, but his blood will I require at thine hand. Nevertheless, if thou warn the wicked of his way to turn from it, if he doth not turn from his way, he shall die in his iniquity, but thou hast delivered thy soul.
There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love. And this place is much brighter than tomorrow. And if you really try, you'll find there's no need. To get there, if you care enough for the living, make a little space, make a better place, heal the world, make it a better place.
So, Mr. Micaiah, is there any other visions you had?
Well, I saw myself on top of the earth as a crystal giant, crystalline, clear, shiny, beautiful. People, all these things I talk about myself, don't ever take the attitude that I'm puffing up myself with pride. See, just like Jesus, how he died and resurrected from the dead, He did all of that to show you that you are also the light, that you are supposed to go to your death believing in your God, that you are to resurrect from the dead, that eternal life is real, that you are, have power to be all sons of God. So these things, what I'm telling you about myself, realize that my life is an example. As Jesus Christ's life was an example, so is my life now an example, so that you could know that I am. So that you can say yourself, I am. And so that when you speak, so did your God speak. So that when they hear you, so have they heard their God. But don't puff yourself up with pride now. You see, because even though I know who I am, I know that no man can be greater than his master. Even though I know that I have come to do greater things than Jesus. You hear me now? I say it. I say, I come to do greater things than Jesus. If I do not do greater things than Jesus, then Jesus and God are liars. If I do not do greater things than Jesus, then it means that I do not have his spirit. And if Jesus Christ's spirit is not in me, then him and God are liars. If Jesus Christ's spirit is not in you, if the spirit of God is not in you, all of you, then God and Christ are liars. And that is impossible. The devil is a liar. And you know what Michael did to the devil? And just as it is in heaven, so shall it be on earth. That's what I have come to do. I saw myself as a crystal giant upon the earth. The earth was in darkness, chaos, sin, and iniquity. I stood as this crystal giant on the earth, and I handed my hand up, my left hand, to the heavens. And I was handed a spike. And this spike was just like my body. Same material as my body. And I bent over, and I plunged that spike into the earth. Boom! And this right hand then became like a hammer. Like Thor's hammer. And I slammed down on that spike. Bam! And the earth split in half. And the two halves of the earth was on both of my sides as I stood in midair between the two halves of the earth. And I simultaneously plunged my hands into the bosoms of both of the halves of the earth. And I swung the both halves of the earth in and out of myself. I had no joints. It went in and out of myself, all through myself, in and out of myself. And when I slammed it back together, bam! The earth became just like I was. Crystal, clear, shining, crystalline, beautiful. And I put the earth, I lifted up over my shoulders. And you know the scripture says, and the government of the world will be upon his shoulders. And I lift up this earth over my shoulders, and Michael of Nebadon, Michael of Nebadon, your universe, my universe, our universe, Jesus Father, our Father. Because we must remember now, Jesus said in John 20 verse 17, touch me not, Mary. This was after his resurrection. I have to go to my Father, that is your Father, and my God, that is your God. What he really meant was that he has to go through the universe through the Son, that is our Father. He had to go through the Son first, Michael of Nebadon, before he get to God in paradise. You feeling me? You understand me? That's why in Revelation chapter 1, verse 5 and 6, it talks about Jesus as the prince of the kings of this earth. And it matches with Daniel 12, that says, Michael, your prince shall rise in the latter days of calamity. And it speaks about deliverance of the people. And it also matches with Revelation chapter 12, where Michael and his angels fought against the dragon, the devil, and defeated the dragon. And this also correlates with Jesus when he said that if you are ashamed to testify my name and profess my name to public before man, so shall I be ashamed of you before my Father and his angels, Michael and his angels that overcome the devil. In Revelation chapter 12, verse 7. And also John 1. Revelation chapter 1, verse 5 and 6, that states, Jesus said the prince of the kings of this earth, and also to God and his Father, which is just like John chapter 20 verse 17, that speaks about, touch me not, Mary, I have to go to my Father, which is your Father, and my God, that is your God, God and the Father again. Michael of the universe, God of paradise. He wanted to make sure you guys know you have a universe, that heaven is real, and it's the universe. There are spirits, there are beings, there are celestials, there are terrestrials. These all are real. The family of God, the infinite family of God, is real. I come to make sure that you know about all these spirits and personalities and powers. I know that many of you speak about all of these aliens, and they're speaking with the aliens. Let me tell you something right now. The Galactic Federations and all these, if they don't profess Michael of Nebadon, if they don't profess Melchizedek, if they don't know Mongeronson, who is Sarara, the magisterial son, if they don't know about the Ancients of Days that is in your book of Daniel's chapter 7 verse 9, all of you needs an education. See, the pastors out there, they teach you partly. They only teach you what they've been taught, what they know. I come to give you the whole truth, not partiality. But the fact of the matter, in ending that vision that I had with the veil over my shoulder, Michael of Nebadon, who is Jesus, who incarnated in Jesus, Yahshua, took the world from me and handed it to the Paradise Trinity, to God in Paradise. The Father in Paradise looked at the Creator Son, Michael of Nebadon, who is Jesus. And then he looked at me. And his look was one of amazement. His expression was one of amazement, as if he was amazed. You might say that, oh, how can God be amazed by anything? God, who knows everything? He cannot be amazed. Boy, let me tell you something. The entire heavens was amazed at Jesus bleeding on the cross, to see how people could be so nasty, so inhumane, so low down, and so when his son died such an ignominious death on the cross, to see how people take the truth and how they treated the truth, and to see how most people today would look at Jesus on the cross and think that they are pleasing to Jesus because they say, Lord, Lord, Jesus, Jesus, and pay some tithes and offerings and go to church on Sunday. And to think of the hypocrisy, and to think of how lazy and laid back the church is today. You're not going to be lazy on my watch. Oh, your soul going to be up and shining on my watch, because I come to lead you all. I come to lead you all out of darkness into the light. But the Paradise Father was amazed at what Christ had done for me, to me, to put himself in me to that extent that I could come out and do the works. So I'm telling you people, and I will break down the heavens to you in another dissertation, not this one, because I intend to be pouring out truth, pouring out my spirit upon all flesh. Yes, I say yes, I am the Messiah. I say yes, I am the revelation and the manifestation of Daniel 12, that Michael, your prince, your guardian, your defender, your deliverer, shall rise in the latter days of calamity, and there shall be a time of trouble like none other, even to nations at that same time. And all the people, all the righteous people who bring many to righteousness, they shall shine as the brightness of the firmament. But all the people that does not bring anything to anybody to righteousness, because you must remember, if you have the light of salvation and you say that you are saved and you are not busy trying to save others, shining that light, then you are not saved. That light will be taken away from you. I come to ensure that you do not have your light taken away from you, that you shine.
in the morning and I ask myself, is life worth living? Should I blast myself? I'm tired of being poor and even worse, I'm blind.